لله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا. لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده، ونصر عبده، وأعز جنده، وهزم الأحزاب وحده، لا شيء قبله ولا شيء بعده. لا إله إلا الله، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. رب اغفر لي ولوالدي، رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا. لا إله إلا الله، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. رب اغفر لي ولوالدي، رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد.
إن شاء الله قلت كذا ويقول ماك تكبير. الله سبحانه وتعالى سال: ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. He says that you should continue or complete the complete number of days of fasting, then you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He guided you to, for helping you to fulfill this act of worship, which is fasting and praying, and all the acts of worship in this blessed month. So make takbir altogether in gratitude and in praise and thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Walillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La
about this in last Friday, and we spoke about this many times before, that the time or the deadline for the charity of al-futr or breaking the fast is the prayer of the Eid. So a Muslim must pay it before the prayer of the Eid. If you paid it before the prayer of the Eid, then congratulations, may Allah accept it. It is an accepted charity inshallah. If you forgot or if you didn't, you should pay it now before we pray. We are about 2 minutes to pray, inshallah. You can pay it in that vase. And you should repent to Allah, actually, because in this short time, you will not be able to give it to those who deserve it. But you should pay it soon before the prayer. And we pray to Allah to forgive us and forgive you. And you should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you should pay it a long time before this. So now, anyway, you should pay it. And you can pay it now before the prayer and ask Allah to forgive you and forgive us all, inshaAllah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا. لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وأزم الأحزاب وحده. لا شيء قبله ولا شيء بعده. لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. رب اغفر لي ولوالدي. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
صلاة العيد إن شاء الله 2 ركعات just like any normal 2 ركعات like Salat al-Fajr for example. The only difference is that in the first rak'ah we make 7 takbirat. In the first rak'ah we make 7 takbirat apart from the first takbirah, so we have 8 takbirat. In the second rak'ah we have 5 takbirat. Between each takbirah, you say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. You can say any of these things. Okay, between each takbirah, you say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Any of these adhkar. Okay? And the rest of the prayer is just like any other prayer.
Do we raise hands with the 7 takbirat?
Yeah, we raise the hands with each takbir. Okay, straight in your line, please. Shoulder to shoulder, no spaces between the shoulders, please. Just leave space for one person in the first row, please. The first and second row, just space for one person. Do not leave spaces between shoulders, please. InshaAllah, after the prayer, we have the short khutbah, inshaAllah. This is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the prayer with the khutbah, inshaAllah. Yeah, put your cell phone off, please, or silent. Istawu. Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر. 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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر 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 الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الله أكبر 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 إن الحمد لله نحمده نستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا All praise and thanks be to Allah We praise Him We seek His help and support We seek His forgiveness نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا We seek refuge in Allah, the Most High, from the evil of our own selves and from our wicked deeds. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له The one who is guided by Allah, no one can misguide him. And the one who is misguided by Allah, no one can guide him. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship but Allah alone without any partner with Him and I bear witness that Muhammad is His servant and messenger اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الأمي الحبيب وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا Allah is greater Allah is the most great لا إله إلا الله All praise and thanks be to Allah over and over again Glorified is Allah Exalted is Allah We glorify Him We thank Him We praise Him day and night, morning and evening. الحمد لله الذي وفقنا للصيام والقيام وطلب العلم وقراءة القرآن. All praise and thanks be to Allah who helped us to do fasting, praying, learning, reciting the Quran. اللهم لولا أنت ما اهتدينا ولا تصدقنا ولا صلينا فأنزلا سكينة علينا وثبت الأقدام يا رب إن لاقينا. Oh Allah, if it was not for you, we would have not been guided, nor gave any charity, nor prayed, nor fasted. So grant us your tranquility and grant us courage at the time of difficulties. اللهم لك الحمد على نعمك وآلائك كلها ما علمنا منها وما لم نعلم. All praise and thanks be to you for all your bounties and favors, those that we know and those that we don't. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, part of the ayah 185, يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر. Allah intends for you ease. Allah wants ease for you, and He never wants to make things difficult for you. He doesn't want difficulty for you. وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. And He wants you to fulfill and to fast the complete number of days of fasting and to make takbir to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to glorify Him, to exalt Him, to thank Him, to do that so that you may be grateful and thankful to Him. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa Allah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. O Lord, we have fulfilled Your command. We have fasted as you commanded us to fast. We have prayed the night of Ramadan as your Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam prescribed for us. So accept from us. You are the most merciful. Dear brothers and sisters, the festivals and the celebrations of Muslims all the time come after the acts of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Eid al-Adha, for example, comes after the worship of pilgrimage. So those who fulfill and go on pilgrimage to Mecca, after they finish, they celebrate this Eid in gratitude to Allah for what He guided them to. And also other Muslims, they celebrate Eid al-Adha after the different kinds of worship in the 9 days of the Hijjah, which are among the best days of the year. And now this is the day of Al-Fitr, the festival of breaking the fast. Why do we have this festival? Why do we have this joy? It is in gratitude and thanks to Allah. Rejoice and happiness with the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with His guidance that we fulfilled His commands. We are happy because we obeyed Him. We rejoice because we fulfilled His commands subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says in the hadith narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim, لِلصَّائِمِ فَرْحَتَان فَرْحَةٌ عِنْدَ فِطْرِهِ وَفَرْحَةٌ عِنْدَ لِقَاءِ رَبِّهِ. Those who fasted, they have two special times to rejoice and to be happy. The first one, when they fulfill their fasting, so they rejoice and they are happy because they fulfilled the command of Allah of fasting. The other one is when they meet their Lord on the Day of Judgment, because their Lord prepared for them a great reward. So that is the second time they will be happy. Happiness and rejoice in gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because He guided us. Because He forgave us. Because He showered us with His mercy, with His blessing in this blessed month. Dear brothers and sisters, Islam is a great religion. It is the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you humble yourself to Allah, when you humiliate yourself before Allah, when you shed some tears to Allah for His fear and His love, this is an act of worship. On the other hand, when you rejoice and when you are happy because He guided you to fast, this is also an act of worship. This is also an obedience, an act of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Yunus, ayah 57 and 58. يا أيها الناس قد جاءتكم موعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور وهدى ورحمة للمؤمنين. All people, an admonition, enlightenment came to you from your Lord, and healing to all the things that troubles your heart, to all diseases of your heart, and guidance and mercy to the believers. Then he says, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِّمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, with Allah's grace and with Allah's mercy, in that let them rejoice. In that, let them be happy. That is better for them than all the wealth they accumulate, all the wealth which pushes them away from obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the wealth that other people accumulate. This is better for you than all that. So with Allah's mercy and Allah's grace on us, we should be happy. We should rejoice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to make us happy. He says in Surah Taha, Taha, ma anzalna alayka al-Quran litashqa. We did not reveal the Quran unto you to be miserable or be unhappy. This means we revealed it to you to be happy. Subhanallah. These teachings, this guidance, this way of life is better for us than all what they accumulate, than all their wealth. And this is why, following the command of Allah in this ayah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to show rejoice and happiness and joy at the day of the Eid. In the day of the Eid, he used to wear new clothes, new garments, special garment for the Eid prayer sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to joke with his companions. He used to listen to some of the nasheed. He allowed them to make some songs and nasheed before him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He allowed them to have permissible amusement and recreation. Yes, dear brothers and sisters, this is Islam, which combines between the needs of the soul and the needs of the body. This is the great religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Islam also puts a great reward for those who make other people happy. Yes, جعل الإسلام الأجر العظيم لمن يدخل السرور على قلوب الناس. If you make people happy, Allah will give you a great reward. Making people happy is greater and better and more rewardable with Allah than the voluntary acts of worship. أفضل من النوافل إدخال السرور على المؤمنين وعلى المسلمين وقضاء حوائجهم أفضل عند الله من النوافل. Listen to your beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. صلوا عليه sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Listen what he says كان بحديث نبات الطائمان الطبراني أحب الناس إلى الله أنفعهم. The most loved creatures by Allah are those who are most beneficial to His creatures. وأحب الأعمال إلى الله سرور تدخله على مسلم. The most loved acts by Allah is happiness that you bring to the hearts of a Muslim. How is that? He says, تكشف عنه قربة. He says, أو تكشف عنه قربة أو تقضي عنه دينا أو تطرد عنه جوعا. What does that mean? He says, you relieve him from distress, from problems or difficulties that he faces, or you pay off his debt or his loans, or you push away hunger from him, you feed him. Then he says, and focus on this, وَلَأَنْ أَمْشِيَ مَعَ أَخِي الْمُسْلِمِ فِي حَاجَةٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ أَنْ أَعْتَكِفَ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ شَهْرًا. And if I walk and go with my fellow Muslim to help him to fulfill some of his needs, this is better and dearer and more love to me than secluding and making i'tikaf in the masjid for one whole month of worship. This is the social side of Islam. The reward of i'tikaf is a great reward. If you make one day of i'tikaf, you will be far from hellfire the distance of seven, or the distance of the east and the west seven times. If you help your Muslims, your Muslim brothers and sisters, it's better for making i'tikaf for 1 month. Subhanallah. This is our religion, dear brothers and sisters. Islam wants to spread happiness and joy and love and fraternity among people. Islam does not want sadness and disappointment to spread. Never. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, in more than 15 verses, He forbids us to be sad. Yes, sadness causes many diseases for the soul and for the body as well. Allah does not want you to be sad. He said in many ayat, do not be sad, do not grieve, do not be grieved, do not be sad by their words, do not be sad by their actions. In another verse He says, in order not to be sad, in order not to be miserable or unhappy. Subhanallah. And our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say a lot, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-hamm wal-hazan. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you. I seek refuge in you from grief and sadness. Allahumma ja'alna min su'ada'id dunya wal-akhirah. Oh Allah, makes us of those who will be happy in this world and in the world to come. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه يغفر لكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. اللهم لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما تحب وترضى. Dear brothers and sisters, this command by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world not to be sad. Now look at the hereafter, a basic reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran more than 7 times. A basic reward in the hereafter is لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. they will have nothing to fear, nor will they grieve. This is one of the basic rewards that Allah will give you on the Day of Judgment in Paradise. They will have nothing to fear. Don't worry about anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you everything. They will have nothing to fear, nor will they grieve. Let us prepare for the eternal happiness and joy. Let us prepare for the ultimate and the eternal success by keeping up fasting. We have now the 6 days of Shawwal. We have many kinds of charity, prayers. Keep up the obligatory prayers in Jama'ah, Salatul Fajr fil Masjid, Khayrun, or considered like Qiyam Layla. Praying the Fajr with the congregation is just as if you prayed the whole night. And the Prophet ﷺ said about the two voluntary prayers before Fajr, he said, رَكْعَتَا الْفَجْرُ خَيْرٌ مِّنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. The two voluntary prayers, two rak'at of voluntary prayers before al-Fajr, before the Fajr prayer, is better than the whole world. So what about the obligatory Fajr prayer? You are close to the masjid. Do your best to come and pray in this masjid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted you this favor that you have a masjid close to your house. Even if it's 15 minutes away, you are getting a great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So keep up seeking knowledge and learning your faith, reciting the Quran, giving charity, being good to others, helping others, introducing Islam to others by your deeds and actions first, and then by your words. So prepare for the eternal success. Listen, what is the eternal success? Listen to this wonderful ayah. Surah Ali Imran, ayah 185.
كل نفس ذائقة الموت وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور.
Everyone will taste death. Even the angel of death will taste death. And you will be paid your wages in full on the day of resurrection, on the day of judgment. And then listen what he says, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever is removed away from the fire and admitted to paradise has indeed succeeded. This is the eternal success. This is the success that you should put before your eyes, should be your ambition, the eternal success and happiness in paradise. The one, Allah is saying, the one who's removed away from the fire and admitted in paradise has indeed succeeded, and the life of this world is only the comfort of illusion, is only a deceiving thing. I remind you finally with the great hadith by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, narrated in Sunan Ibn Majah and Abi Dawud and others. He says sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the hadith narrated by Abdullah bin Salam, ya ayyuhan nas, O people, abshu salam wa at'imu at'am وَصِلُوا الْأَرْحَامِ وَصَلُّوا بِالْلَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامِ تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ بِسَلَامِ. Narrated by Abdullah bin Salam. Very wonderful hadith. All people, spread peace and the greeting of peace among yourselves, and feed others, and be careful and dutiful to your relatives, and pray at night when people are sleeping. Then you will enter paradise with peace. Do not forget in this Eid to communicate with your relatives and your friends.
to take care of them, to help them when they need, to support them. And do not forget your Muslims, your fellow Muslims, your Muslim brothers and sisters who are suffering in Syria. Do not forget them from your prayers and from your practical financial support, continuous support. Do not forget all your Muslim brothers and sisters who are suffering everywhere. Keep them in your prayers. Purify your hearts. Reconcile your disputes. Never leave any room for hatred in your hearts towards your fellow Muslims. Never put any hatred in your hearts towards Muslims. صفوا قلوبكم أصلحوا ذات بينكم لا تدعوا مكانا للحقد في قلوبكم على إخوانكم. If you want Allah to forgive you, then forgive your Muslim brothers and sisters. بشرى لمن صلى وصام بشرى لمن قام بشرى لمن تلا القرآن بشرى لمن طلب العلم بشرى لمن حصل مغفرة الله سبحانه وتعالى بشرى لمن اعتق من النار في هذا الشهر. Congratulations and great glad tidings for those who fasted and prayed, those who sought knowledge and learned, those who recited the Quran and supplicated, those who asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, and those who repented. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات المسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا مولانا سميع قريب مجيب للدعوات. Oh Allah, forgive Muslims and believers, men and women, the dead and the living ones. اللهم تقبل منا صلاتنا وصيامنا وأذكارنا وركوعنا وسجودنا تامة يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعلنا ممن أعتقت رقابهم في هذا الشهر الكريم. اللهم اجعلنا من الربانيين ولا تجعلنا من الرمضانيين. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يعبدك طوال العام بهمة عالية يا أرحم الراحمين. Oh Allah, accept our fasting and prayers. Forgive us our sins and negligence, and make us of those who worship you all the year and not only in Ramadan. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Oh Allah, grant us good in this life and in the hereafter, and save us from hellfire. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. متعنا اللهم بأبصارنا وأسماعنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. اللهم هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا. اللهم أصلحنا وأصلح بنا وأصلح ذات بيننا. Oh Allah, guide us and make us guides to others. اللهم فرج عن أهلنا في الشام ما هم فيه يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم كن معهم ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم اقبل شهداءهم. اللهم عاف جرحاهم. اللهم فك أسراهم، اللهم انصرهم على من ظلمهم وعاداهم يا أرحم الراحمين. Oh Allah, give relief to our brothers and sisters in Syria and everywhere. Oh Allah, accept their martyrs. Give speedy recovery to the injured ones. Help them to release their prisoners. Grant them victory over their enemies. You are the most powerful. You are the most strong. You are the most merciful. اللهم عليك بالطغاة المجرمين في كل مكان فإنهم لا يعجزونك. اللهم أرنا فيهم عجائب قدرتك. Oh Allah, defeat and destroy all oppressors and tyrants everywhere. No one can defeat you. Glorified is you. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. May Allah accept your deeds. May Allah make it a blessed Eid. And may your faith and your wealth, may your faith and your wealth be increased. May may Allah accept your deeds. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with us all. تقبل الله منا ومنكم وكل عام وأنتم بخير إن شاء الله.
بكره عنده خطه الجمعه وبعدين نستلم.